Thank you for your time.
Yeah, yeah, sure. Pleasure.
So we're going to start from the beginning then. Well, mm-hmm. when you are imagining a space mm-hmm. in Jogja, whether or not it is, in the beginning of your interaction in Jogja, do you find space as a basic need, or is it scarce or anything?
You mean when opinion? I was Dharma Siswa and I was first time in Indonesia and in Jogja?
Yeah, probably that, or probably when you have the idea to develop a space, or
yeah, actually it's not really like I'm artist and I open my art space mm-hmm. because it's not really art. I mean, it's art space, but in the concept of creating kind of community. So when I first time was in Indonesia, what I get in here is like the people not really work individual, mm-hmm. they're working in a community mm-hmm. together, they're working together. So when I back to Poland, I was trying to adapt kind of style in here to Poland. And it was working and not, because it's different backgrounds and people behave different, and also Indonesia have really big tradition about working together. Mm-hmm. So it's even in the village, they mm-hmm. have the Gotong Royong tradition, and so the idea to create the Sesama actually is kind of bigger thing connected to the foundation I work with, Razem Pomoże Foundation. So the space we create after we develop the project Hati Hati Hat. Mm-hmm. It was exhibited in Galerie Nationale in Jakarta. The project was the part of the bigger Polish artist exhibition Social Design for Social Living. And this Hati Hati Hat project, we invite 60 Polish artists to redesign and think about the colonial hat, the colonial topi. Mm-hmm. So they sometimes just redesign, paint something on it, but some of them, they was leaving the instruction for performative, like they suggestion for performative activity in Jakarta. Mm-hmm. So like I'm normally performance artist mm-hmm. and Justyna, my girlfriend, and we together create the space in here. We was trying to make the action on the street with the people mm. or create a situation, documentate, and after we make the internet auction mm. of these hats mm. and grow fundings to build this space in here. Mm. So actually this is how also Razem Pomoże Foundation working. So the first Razem Pomoże Foundation, they create the art gallery in Madhare slums in Nairobi, in Kenya. And they start to work with the community. They also pay the scholarships for some most talented high school students there. Mm. And they renovation the school and make kind of cooperative places so that people can get knowledge how to, for example, make the shoes, or how to sew the dress, the fashion. So they can after that have some like course and make them they earn job, like something like that. Mm-hmm. So and so there is three galleries. The first one was in Kenya. The second one is in Krakow. So in Krakow is more like white cube mm-hmm. space. So we showing there the effects of Kenya projects. We try to connect artists with this place, because we are based on non-government, non-profit mm-hmm. funding. So the funding is coming from the auction we organize every year, mm-hmm. and the artists are philanthropes. Mm-hmm. They're giving us the artworks because they're happy with our mission, and we put these works on the auction. Mm-hmm. That's how we get fundings for the next step in Kenya, now in here, and in Krakow.
Mm-hmm. So is the scheme, similar scheme will be done here?
Because these three places have different background, and this area in Matara is really in the slums, bad area, poor area. In here is we're trying to develop different thing, also related with the mission about education. But in this year we will try to focus on how art can help with the education about the waste management and recycling plastic, which is problem not only here in Poland, also in Kenya also. So that's why we developed the program with Wayang Plastic for the children, Limbach Berbuni Trash Concert. So the monk and friends was, they build the instruments and they playing on it on the gamelan set, the composition of them. So, and we also would try to make something kind of like platform for exchange Polish European artists with Indonesian, because I believe that it's too much white artists in Georgia, and there's not so many Indonesian, for example, artists or Asian artists in Europe, because you know it's kind of colonial thing still in this case. So what is really my dream is to try to help the Indonesian artists also to come to Poland, for example, or to Kenya to work. So we already have one exchange. Dadi Setiadi was in Krakow this January and to present his artworks in the foundation space in Krakow. And probably in May we will have Monk and his Limbach Berbuni concert in Krakow space. So it kind of exchange. So some of the projects will do it here and move there in some or some part of them. So.
But the decision of what kind of project can be done is how is it organized? Is it organized between the three spaces, or you can decide?
What
kind of project you?
Yeah, I can decide. I mean, I'm not really decide myself. I'm trying to create a situation when everybody can decide actually. So it's like open, but like the main idea we created together with the foundation, but somehow the program idea of how to build the program, me and Justyna, we build this, but it's kind of open. So we many times working on the open call for anybody, even not artists, because this project about us is kind of open call for the artists in Yogyakarta, but we also our dream was to connect them with the local people. And actually in here there was the Ibu really happy to come here and work with the artists, because they know batik but they don't know technique and they don't know how to make it. So even they are from Indonesia, they really want to work on it and having fun also. So and actually we have already two residency artists in here. They already left Poland. One of is Przemek Branas. He was making this Gerobak Anklinger project. And the second is Agnieszka Brzeżańska. She's artist from Poland also, working with the foundation. And she was participating in this project idea. So we, me and Agnieszka, we create the concept of how if we trying to think what is mean Sesama. For the people and how to show what it, and what is mean flag, is mean territory, and we explain our idea to Ibu and the artists, so they trying to find what is mean for them Sesama. So this flag is kind of answer for this question in chill out way. Because for me it was most interesting to see how they connect together. So I'm also working with them. to don't make, because it's like Sesama, so even in Java there is kind of still hierarchy. So like one of the mission is like equal, so we all same. I'm artist, I can be farmer, and a farmer is farmer, but he can be artist, doesn't matter. So we want to try to show the people they all the same, and there is no borders, hopefully. Of course there is in the culture and the differences, but how to break it is also fun.
Yeah, talking about the cultural barriers probably, of entering a city as the art scene of Jogja. I'm sure you have few opinions. Feel free to share that about the opinions, but also in retrospect, when you were a student, and but you're still studying, right?
No. It was 1 year program in Dharma Siswa in ISI for 2012-2013. So I was just after graduate, I come here, I apply for the scholarship and I get it, and I come here for 1 year. So it was just 1 year program in ISI.
Okay.
During this year, I was like traveling and meeting people.
Yeah. So after you came back and you decided to open a space, regardless of the positive and negative responses, what does it mean to be accepted and to be able to
It's funny because I don't know real opinion of Javanese people because Javanese artists in Jogja because how you know like of course you know guys. In Javanese style, there is not people not complain many times. So there is there is many gossips. For example, I don't mean about Sasama, but in general. So actually, people was really interesting in what we doing here. I mean, why and of course sometimes they think it's my private space, but it's not really my private space. We're trying to give it to the people and it's like open for everyone. And most of the galleries are not open for everyone. I mean, they like limited, so there's only artists, and on opening there's only artists coming, and so it's created something like kind of, you know, closed cycle. It's also happening in Poland. But what I get when I was first time here, even there is important galleries, famous, provided with artists, there's people working not in the mainstream, but they're doing art and they do activity in their cycle. They have community, like Omach Bohon, for example, or like many other communities in here. Like Performance Club of Iwan Wijono. It's like ephemeral thing, yeah? They don't even have a real building, but the idea is kind of the building. So they met with the occasion of making something together. And that was interesting for me. So, of course, here is many individual artists, but in Poland is a lot of individual artists. No many people working together on something like in here, which is not, I don't criticize it because it's different here, different there. It doesn't matter. Like, we don't need to criticize this style. But what I get is more interesting for me, the style, like what I see here. To work together, because when you work together with other people, with the people with the different backgrounds, different countries, you can get the more knowledge. Then you can work individually with the theory from the books and from the art history actually. And so actually this place is also kind of educative for me, which is my private most happy thing. But all idea is kind of open for everybody and really open for people idea. So I'm trying every time in my life never say no. And this and this kind of
becoming a Japanese.
Yeah, I mean, but in a positive way. I mean, because artists asking me like, so we can make here exhibition of painting. I mean, you can, but how you will explain to the local people what is this? Because they don't really into this kind of art. Because the, so they start to think how to make maybe something new connected with the art, but how to include local community to work together. I mean, because what I find in art world is boring. I'm only artist in here, and I'm not really making objects in my art. I'm not making paintings, so I'm based on the performative way. So it's kind of make gatherings, for example, or things, because and it's different. The art market, of course, the part of the Sasama and mostly the foundation, because mm-hmm. they need to be a part of art market, but mm-hmm. these three galleries are really not, so because we just make a gathering, actually, not really mm-hmm. selling art. We don't selling here anything, mm-hmm. because we don't want, mm-hmm. we don't profit, because we don't want any income. The income coming from the artist philanthropy, because these artists who give work to the foundation, they already maybe success, famous, and they mm. from abroad, of Poland also, from New York, something. So if they see our mission, they like, okay, so we can give you this work, you sell it, you make another good thing. Mm. Or not. I mean, I cannot say it because it's my private opinion also.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So how do artists in Jogja, or is it also coming from outside of Jogja, people who want to do project in Sasama?
I mean, it's still fresh place somehow. Mm-hmm. So now we really, really focus on making full program. I mean, still going on. So every month is couple events ongoing. And we will try after this to give this space to the local people, because I need to, for example, back to Europe for growing Sasama image there. I mean, to talking with artists, how to create the, you know, exchange thing, how to make this platform for exchange. So in this summer we will experiment with this. But actually, I think in Poland we call it Poczta Pantoflowa. It's kind of people one by one inform each other. Oh, there's the space like this, or friends bring friends, or someone here like you about this, and see on, for example, on Facebook. So, and people like coming here and propose something, and we discuss how to do that actually. And also we, like I am making also my research about these targets we have about recycling plastic, so on, and trying to create already the program to show people how it should work. I mean, how we want to it should work. I mean, kind of showing people what is the style of the work here. I mean, the work or the gathering, or how to, you know, what is the idea of the space, which is not really art gallery. It's like art space. It's like community cultural house, something like this. Because we have art here, but we have also meeting of Bapa Bapa and Ibu from the village. So they're using this space to gathering, because they have many like kind of things to talk about the village. We'll also try to participate and trying to help them to grow the program of Visit Jablok, Seni Creative, Campus Seni Creative.
Oh yeah.
So we will try to trying to put the Bank Sampah program in a village. So our friend from is a young leader of Pemuda in Jablok. So he also like kind of working with us, really like we really connected together, and we're trying to create the program together. So connected with the young people here, with the community here, and yeah, and we want to make some English lessons for the open for public, and this wine plastic program. There is also on this exhibition the group of gamelan from the village was happy to play on the scene with us. Ooh. So some of the Ibu which are joining the gamelan group, they also make the flags. So it's kind of find also the way how to work together and how we can work together, and because we can exchange the knowledge to each other. I mean, I learned a lot in Indonesia, and I'm really happy about this. Because here it is more calm down, people not so stressed. I mean, they're stressed, but kind of...
Yeah, daily needs.
Yeah, exactly.
So I'm beginning to understand more about the intention of the space.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it's interesting that you are quite accommodative in the idea of Kampung Seni Kreatif, but then connecting it with Bank Sampah. Somehow, I haven't been able to look at either it's called the Kampung Seni Kreatif, if my assumption is confirmed, yeah. Because in the city, there are also tourism kampungs that is yeah. That's prone to be another top-down system.
I know what you mean also, because I'm also when we was talking about this program with the village, I was like, because like why you want this program actually?
Uh-uh.
Yeah, because we want people to visit the place.
Mm.
Okay, but for what actually?
Mm.
Because there's many like manufacturer, there's many gallery around here. The people making frames there. There is like bamboo furniture there. There is one ibu specialized in coloring batik, for example. Ah, there is the company who's making this stove for wax. And we will see. I don't know why they need tourists here.
Mm-mm.
That's interesting for me.
Mm-mm.
But it also may be interesting for tourists. If they are really interested in it, the tourism is the bad thing for me, actually, because the tourists like hang out on the beach and drinking beer, and actually they're interested not in the culture, but they're like interested in relax. So even for me, I'm in Poland, I'm from the hometown near the Baltic Sea, so I know what it means tourism every summer.
Okay.
And what people do, and exactly they do the same here, and they make it in my hometown. But you know, for European, it's kind of like fancy to come to Bali for exactly the same beach like in Barcelona or in Italy or whatever. But what is interesting, because of course many tourists are interested in the culture, so if they visit village like this, they like, wow, this is different than in my country, because the people in village working together, they are part of bigger city, Mission District Georgia, but they have many like small manufacturer here.
Mm-hmm.
And but for me also interesting how it will work. I mean, how to, for one visit, show to the tourist what is real essential of the life in here,
yeah.
And art in here, because I'm already here only 2 years and I still, every day is new info for me and new something, and wow, something like, wow, new. Interesting. Mm. So, for example, in April, we make a street art festival in Jablok.
Okay.
It's kind of first step to make this program Visit Jablok more essential and more success.
Mm-hmm.
So we invite Andres Bustrianto to work with us, but the concept is totally different than other festivals. So we invite the street artist, but they need to work with the young people here and the owners of the houses. So they were working together to make Jablok more colorful or whatever they want, actually, because I don't really know what people need here for them, especially because I'm not so long time in here.
Mm-hmm.
It's also interesting, so we'll try to make this step to get knowledge about what they want by easy step through art. So hopefully it will be full.
The plan is
to make it from like 15 April until end of April.
Okay. Oh, it's next month, yeah?
Yeah, that's next month, yeah.
Kayaknya udah, Ben. Yeah, I think we could stop recording.
Oh, yeah.
Ben.
Apa?
udah selesai.
Dia tuh ini. Tetap merekam kalau
kamu tetap merekam.
Tetap.
Wede.
Ya.
Terus nanti diedit tuh, Ben.
Iya tuh.
ada.
Oh ya.
Yeah, I don't know if you smoke.
How if what people here need is not street art? Why the frame street art?
I mean they actually choose it.
Oh,
they asking me because they only talk together. Because
they want mural or something.
Yes,
like that.
Oh.
Yeah.
They want it.
That's
why we help them to develop the program.
Mm-hmm.
So the Bakhtiar, leader of the young people, like Adam, maybe street art.
Mm-hmm.
They also try to find what is good or what is not. I mean, this for everything activity is good for me,
mm-hmm.
but it's also kind of if the because this is kind of first step to preparation for the Mertidesa on the end of the year.
Mm. Oh.
So we will try to show the young people how to organize, how to, because it will be like kind of how to experience for them, so they can be ready for the bigger thing.
Mm.
Because to make festival is quite like big thing, so you can plan, talking, description, project, make the mock-ups, get materials, how to find solutions, manage solutions, talking with the owner is kind of diplomacy in here. So it will be kind of training also for the young people. So I'm not really interested in what it will be on the mural, but kind of what we can give to the young people here so they can get experience and get knowledge how to organize the thing. So the Sesama will be like base for this. We'll help them, support, and trying to show them, because I already experienced how to make such a big thing and small thing, so I can share my knowledge with them how to do that. And Andres also, because he already made this Genteng theater festival, a big one. We try also to invite one Polish artist, and for sure we want to mix it like woman and man. So it's not only like a man artist, which is like kind of be kind of overdose for me in Yogyakarta. It's like my exhibition everywhere, and okay, cool, thank you. It's boring.
Yeah. The thing about Kampung projects is that in some ways, I see that there's always budget, annual budget from the government, right?
Oh yeah, for example, they have this Lele pool for here. They have the Lele fishing place.
Oh yeah.
So the government support this place.
By request from the village or?
Yeah, they put the project, and I was really shocked about this. I mean, in Poland it's also like that, but kind of different way. And here just Kampung apply for the projects and they get the fundings to build the Lele place. So it's kind of interesting.
It's possible to propose, but not many village propose.
Yeah.
So sometimes it's...
I mean, this village is really active before, okay. Sesama, really active. They already made this paring trahir 3 years ago and 4 years ago when I was here in Dramasiswa. I even don't know it was this place actually. I was like, wow, this is this place? Wow, it's amazing, because I was really impressed with the scale of Mertidesa in here. So remember this old brain in the rice fields and these big sculptures and these last harvest performances, wow. And actually they organized this village, so they're really, really active. They're really active and really well organized to... So Sesama is kind of place of exchange, so we can get knowledge from them, they can get knowledge from them, from us, exchange and create something together in way of Sesama.
Okay. But as a project, it is planned for 2 years in duration.
I mean, no, it's, we don't, I mean, I never put a limit, I mean, and foundation also don't put the limit. I mean, I hope it can work as long as we can do that, I mean.
Also in terms of running the space? In terms of, if you return to Europe, then...
Of course, will be, yeah, it will be.
I will
just working online.
Oh,
we already have some kind of team here.
They
cannot come today, actually, but there is a team of people. They're already happy to work with us, like a volunteer or something also. And local people also. So the space will be live, even I'm in Europe, because actually I'm going back because visa and stuff, and I need to... I have many also my cases in Poland, but I can handle it online. I'm about the program, because we already create some kind of plan, so we just need to keep the plan, and it also will be experience for the team how to handle it without me, because I'm really important in here. I mean, I'm just here, you know, initiation, but like come on, like people can do that also. I believe it. I believe in people, because people are great here. They can do that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because also back to Europe, I have a couple of meetings. There are the couple of galleries and organization in Poland. They wanna make a program with us about sending in Czech Republic. Already we have confirmation that there's people want to make the program with us, so the artist can also make proposition what they can do, so I can connect them with the villagers and they can start working together, or not, or it can be in Georgia, but we have already couple meetings in May and June about the future residency artist program in here. So of course the foundation have many suggestions. I mean, this Hati Hat project, we have 60 artists and somehow they know our mission and we will happy to have them here, but it depends to the fundings. For example, for this street art festival, we're trying to apply for the like fundings from one Polish artist to the government. It's our first try because we believe that the foundation money can use in good way, better than buying ticket, which is expensive, for example. Yeah. So hopefully this space can be also independent financially from the foundation, because when you open and call the residency program around the world, so normally you need to pay for the residency, and in here you don't need so much actually. It can be like $100 or $200 per month. We have the room, blah blah blah, so we can provide the service, I mean, and materials, and how to use this money to support community.
Okay. Yeah. That's very visible. So you learn from many interactions, I believe, from people.
Yeah.
You say there's so many white people, but not much are giving back.
Oh yeah, even when I was Dharma Sistha, it's like, come on, like these people like only hang out with that, with Dharma Sistha, like, because maybe the language is the like also the problem here. Like I'm not really speaking Bahasa well, but I'm trying to learn. But actually, sometimes people only speak Javanese, so
yeah,
it's also good. But actually, I'm more interested in Javanese, but I don't know Javanese. I need to learn Bahasa more, but still. Time is limited for me sometimes. Yeah, but about the it depends, of course. Many white people coming here, and they already have like
fixed plan.
They don't really patient to make interaction.
Oh.
Because they coming from like Europe or Australia, they have like targets. They have like aim. They really straight about their time. And they cannot be chill in here to find how it's in here, because they don't understand Santai and they don't understand jump karet, they don't understand. But to be, to accept being here is kind of trying to stop yourself and trying to understand, listen to the people and hear the stories. And for me it's important here to talk with locals, meet with the locals and Indonesians and whatever, and interesting.
But do many people also tell you about how difficult it is to be an artist outside of Jogja? Or?
Ah, yeah, I know, because the Jogja is kind of like artist city, special district of art. And yeah, I can imagine the being artist outside of Jakarta, like art scene is hard.
But also in Poland, yeah, is it centralized or you can find artists everywhere?
I mean, not really. I mean, of course you can find everywhere, but the most successful people like Warsaw, in Krakow, in Poznan, in Gdańsk.
Oh, it's even more.
In Wrocław. Yeah, but it's different. Yeah, it's different type of the, you know.
Development.
And you have Berlin, you have Prague. You have London, you have Paris, and Düsseldorf and Köln, Karlsruhe in Germany, many places, but the cities are big. And there's Gilang, one of the team of Sasama. Yeah, I'm interested of his opinion also about this. Okay. Yeah, that will be great. Uh-huh. That will be great. Because actually we should be here like
the
whole team. I mean the
how
team is like
is in the
it
team.
Depends. Mm. I mean we don't really have like hours because on the Facebook we write 24 hours open 7 days a week because it's true if someone comes to the door we like open it's okay.
But how many people in the team?
I mean it's not really team like in work. It's like community trying to like community. So maybe I don't know. 10, 20, I don't know. Mm. Because but these old people have their own jobs and so when we start to create something we try to call or if you are interested to develop with us, just come and we sit together and talk, discussion. Mm. Ilang?
Yeah.
I want to invite you to the discussion.
Who?
You.
Really?
Yes. Thank you. You know each other? You know each other?
Not yet.
Kilan.
Tia.
Tia. Kilan.
Pitra.
These beautiful people coming from the IFA, International Visual Art Archive, to talk about Sesama and our thing. So I already talked so much, blah, 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 blah. So we really want to know your opinion.
Ditambahin. Baru mau nanya Asma. Yeah.
Sorry man, can you? I don't know when I pull it. Oh yeah, where? Wait.
Si baru mau ngerokok mau nanya Asma.
Because you know, I was talking alone, and I was like, fine, like, no, I'm not alone, Sesama. You know, Sesama is the people, so it's so good. Actually, like, yes, that you come is like, I am a coincidence. Mm. So
always
you can also, put your opinion on this, because there's many art community in here, like. On the first exhibition in the booklet you have this like Confab Lab and the Performance Lab and Tiny Party, Kirchbergerak. So the also our dream was how to connect them. So maybe this is somebody's space they can meet also and talk about something sometimes.
Oh, with one another?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Yeah. But do you see that they are not connected already or?
They connected. I mean they know each other. Yeah. They know each other but they have, you know, everybody have their own job, they have separate missions sometimes. Mm-hmm. I mean Taring Padi already not so active like before. Which is connected with many reasons actually, you know, also. And Performance Club still active and you are doing many things right now. Mm. You opened the River House and developed the program there. Before he was living in this street here.
Yeah.
Our neighbor before. And yeah, Kesselbergerak is so active and they make so beautiful project right now, the Kampung magazine. Mm-hmm. So they develop, I think, with couple Kampungs, the magazine based on local news, something like this. And Honfab Lab is so active, like crazy, they're so busy and they going to Singapore to make some crazy spaceship, NASA.
Oh yeah, the UFO project, yes.
No, I'm really crazy about this activity also, but yeah, like in Kesselbergerak is really based on like Kampung local activity, Performance Club half-half also, it's kind of artists, like community of performance artists, but they're also really active with showing opinion about the conditions of actual situation everywhere in the world, in Indonesia. Time Party also. Kind of same, and yeah, and Honfab Lab doing also many projects, also including thinking about how to develop open source idea for example, Kampung, how to make benzene from the plastic bottles or something like this. Mm-hmm. So also we also will try to connect our residency artists with these communities, so they can also look how they work, and. The field of working together. It can be Sesama, but it can be Honf, it can be other community also. But in the first exhibition, we just include these four, because I think it's the spectrum of some kind of activity in Georgia. But there's so many, like, mm-hmm. I even don't know all, because how to know all, because some of them are not really kind of famous in media, or people don't talk about it, but there's so many activity in Georgia, and the people like, and sometimes they come to me like, wow, this community, they're working about something, wow, I didn't hear about it. And you guys, like IVA, is kind of organization, but you also you are also kind of a, like community.
Yeah, we haven't decided yet to be what kind of formally it is an organization. Mm-hmm, formally, mm-hmm. It has responsibilities to its funding,
mm-hmm.
because when I came in, it was already running for 10 years under a funding scheme, but then the founders also, they had projects that is said that this is kind of the Jogja spirit during their time. I can't really say what they did unless we look at the documentation and ask how it was in Jogja.
Sure.
And well, even at the time, there were not so many people calling themselves artists, or not everyone is comfortable in calling themselves artists. But over time, gradually, I think people are more comfortable with the title, because it's not just about their generation have become established artists, especially part of the community that they developed. It was called the Cemeti Art Foundation. And when it became IFA, actually it was just about running a library and how to maintain the documents that they
have collected. The database. Mm-hmm. It's really impressive. It was there,
We haven't been able to actually do a proper outreach outside of the arts community. There's quite a difficult challenge when bringing these materials even to art school, because then not everyone is. Especially, the students, if they are not doing a research for part of their study or whatever, you may not be able to find the use of these materials. What we have in mind about outreach is more about using how artists can actually activate the older materials, because when you look at projects by projects, of course there's always a personal touch of the creative endeavors inside, but there's also patterns that you can look at, and it's not just about research. So but that kind of exploration is actually not making us becoming a real community-based outside of the art scene. So it's mainly, it needs more people to work on the archive activation.
Oh yeah.
Of course, I mean we can only analyze from experience
of
the
course
artist,
yeah.
Make it at least something that is readable or
But you are supported by some like cultural ministry in Indonesia?
No,
it's like totally also outside of the because I mean in Poland when the people create archives or something like performance art archives, They many times supported by some government program because they have some kind of like, we need to archive the Polish art for future, and there is couple or programs you can apply to make, for example, book about some artists and about some activity or festival or something. Yeah. So it's also tricky, of course,
yeah.
Because you know, because it's government decide. Oh, this is, we give money for this one and this not. Why? Who knows? This is this, like, you know, like every competition, there is jury and this is like subjective opinion about what is good or what is not. And also art institution in Poland, like Museum of Modern Art and the biggest gallery, also funded by government, they also have money for publication, kind of archives also.
Yeah, I think when and when it comes to,
I mean, the initial structure of the like, yeah. Yeah, it's totally different. This is what I get also in Galerie Nationale in Jakarta. I mean, it's,
oh yeah, you work with them, yes.
Yeah, yeah, it was, you know, can I not say my opinion on the camera? Like,
no, no, it's
you can
like,
cut,
yeah,
you can cut.
Yeah, we will.
It was strange for me, and interesting also because so many people working there, but they just walking around. I think. That's funny. And, yeah. That's funny. I mean, and there is nothing in Jakarta, even nothing like the Museum of Modern Art. Many museums, of course, but kind of place to show. I mean, it's supposed to be Galerie Nationale, but they have also exhibition of the watches there. I hear like or something like this. I hear also. And after our exhibition, there was the exhibition of. Collection of some collector of the clocks or watches.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, something
it's
like
rented,
this.
Yeah. Yeah? Is they rented?
Yeah, exactly.
To fund the operations. Although it is the biggest, probably the biggest art institution in Indonesia, they still have money problems. Because then it has to be reported, otherwise they can be, you know, use of corruption because it's different from the proposal. But I think also they're not really quite visionary or experimental in terms of programming. So
because the Ministry of Culture is taking care about Galerie Nationale, yeah?
Not really. Yeah.
Not really.
Formally, yeah.
Formally, because yeah, because my invitation for visa when we're going to was officially like Ministry of Cultural and Education. So I'm just curious because these galleries in Poland is also like kind of under the Ministry of Culture and Art and Education. But yeah, decision is of course in the galleries, I mean.
Yeah, it was once part of the tourism and culture.
Oh yeah,
because
tourism,
of changes
culture.
All kind of. Right now it's education and culture again. So maybe there's...
Oh, the same they make in Poland right now, I think. the separation, yeah, kind of the same.
It really depends on what kind of international agreement the government has signed. If it's to get greater GDP...
But what they get from artists in here, they really won't have exhibition there.
They want to have more exhibitions.
They really want to have exhibition, individual, for example, or group in Galerie Nationale. Even everybody now is
of. Right now, the artists.
I mean, right now, yeah. I mean, right now, yeah. So
yeah,
it's mean the Galerie Nationale can be connected with the art market success of individual
not
artists.
Not really.
But so
you can get the it's more about building a reputation.
Yeah, because if you have exhibition in MoMA in New York, you can get really good income also because the collectors are coming there and the people who are buying art are going there. So if artists interested in art market, they like, oh yeah, MoMA, yeah. So I can sell my work higher price or something like this. Yeah.
Well, I don't think if it's that.
Yeah, that's interesting.
Pragmatic, yeah. Because then no one can guarantee your. Your. Reputation.
Of course, of course, yeah. Interesting. That's interesting.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe what is more promising for contemporary artists is not the market, but the opportunity to explore the world.
Oh yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, oh, the opportunity to travel, to be exposed to other cultures. It looks more promising for mm-hmm. people, yeah, but not really about getting money from selling work.
Oh yeah.
It's usually outside of the contemporary scene, yeah. So different. Mm-hmm. But also it has its own problems because then you don't really know. Not everyone, it's not part, I don't know right now, at least in EC, mm-hmm. do they teach people to, their students to be able to, travel or...
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I was there and they not teach me. Skip.
I mean, you know, about in Poland, about art education is really good, but about how to develop your career, you need to make it yourself.
Okay.
I mean, actually, in many schools, but in my department, intermedia was good. I mean, because
they provide options.
And, I mean, they provide option because I was the first student department. So there was not many students, we only 10, and so kind of we create the program for the future with the teachers. So we have a really comfortable situation because for the start of intermediate department in Krakow, they have many grants and fundings to trying to put us in international projects.
Mm.
So we get this experience like a little bit automatically, which teach us also how to exist after the studies. And which is like, you know, applying, asking, and begging, or something like, you know, which is crazy in the art world, like, because the big position in art world have curators and galleries, and artists are somewhere like, far, it's like far away, which is funny.
Yeah.
I believe that art school or art college always provide the student opportunity,
mm-hmm.
but the detail how it works, it kind of like personally research by the student. Yeah, the information.
Yeah, you will not know without experience on yourself. Yeah.
I believe they still provide it. Even the smallest chance,
mm-hmm.
they still. But I'm not sure.
You believe, but you are not sure.
Coba cerita baik, ambil institusi.
Ya nggak apa-apa sih, karena memang nggak ditambah juga tuh institusinya. Itu saja.
I was speaking bahasa.
Oh yeah, sure, please. No worries.
Aku nggak ngelihat opportunity-nya masih kayak di papan pengumuman tuh
itu
pasti
ada.
Mm-hmm. Pasti ada. Cuma gimana tuh cara apply-nya? Setidaknya bimbingan kayak itu yang nggak ada.
Perjalanan menuju mendaftar itu ya.
Itu paling mudah loh, maksudnya kenapa nggak diajarkan untuk mendaftarnya dulu aja. Kalau teknik, aku yakin semua yang
itu harus dicoba,
keterima gitu. Di institusi udah pasti punya teknik masing-masing. Tapi
jalannya.
Ability to exist in this world, they don't teach us.
Because how, man, the teachers are artists also, but they are in the school and have regular work. They don't need to worry about it. So they don't need, they don't have this idea to teach you how you can survive if you don't have the real work, like it's in school, in whatever, in office, And working like freelancer is hard everywhere.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, it's hard everywhere.
Mm.
Because your money coming sometimes not.
That's the truth. Behind this beautiful scene.
Yeah. well, yeah, to my personal opinion, if people think that Jogja is comfortable this way for artists, I think everyone should try to make it always comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, without any kind of, you know, it's not about how you work, but it's more about the change of the city itself, because then a lot of investments, mm-hmm, coming,
mm-hmm,
it, yeah, probably will transform the city into something cold like Jakarta or, mm-hmm, something like that. It's more difficult for
interesting
people to.
So what I get last week, there Jakarta is like 6% more expensive than Warsaw and Prague.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, in general statistic. So I was really like, because people, tourists, I mean, mm-hmm, coming here like, yeah, we come to Indonesia, so cheap in here, blah, mm-hmm, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's maybe cheap makan.
Cheap makan, yeah, yeah. Everything else.
Yeah, that's what I find. And also there's the difference between when I was here in 2012.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Already different.
Already different, and even the Pertamina price is higher than
before.
Oh,
bensin.
Yeah. And I hear 10 years ago, 15 years ago, the 1 liter of benzene was maybe 1,000, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. And now it's 8, maybe, yeah?
In those old era.
Yeah, because the least that we can do is working for... Yeah, it's not to generate money.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
You cannot depend on the art market, right?
Of course. And I don't believe it actually. Also,
yes,
yeah, because you cannot
here
sell performance art. Or if they buy your body,
yeah, yeah,
and use like puppet, of course, but nobody.
But for how long?
Yeah, for how long? You know?
20 minutes or more. At least about creating project that can sustain and doesn't have to worry about money.
We need to worry about the money. Still.
Yeah, the money for food, yeah.
Exactly.
But money for.
Yeah, actually, it's a trap because we worry, but for example, we can find opportunity how to grow your own food, but nobody have a time because everybody worry how to get money for food, and this is like, mm-hmm, kind of tricky. And yeah, I'm wondering in Indonesia how many people really don't spend any money, they grow themselves, they eat what they grow.
It's very little.
Very little.
Mm.
But before, but in the history of Indonesia, it was many, I think, because...
Well, there was this...
In Poland also, now it's crap already, you know? People in Kampung, they don't even have chicken.
Yeah.
In Poland. And here's still money. I mean, you know, in the cow, there's no cow in Poland because we still from the Polish village, so now there's no, maybe her uncle has one. Just to remember old times.
Uh-uh.
Yeah, not really, like. So. Interesting.
Well, a lot of. Infrastructure development is actually on productive land.
Yeah.
But if you go back in time, the issue is, the issue began right after the Green Revolution.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So when you start having monoculture, just padi or just kelapa sawit.
Generated by old government.
Mm-mm. So you need to really dismantle everything.
But actually, there is a kind of like permaculture idea. So, mm-hmm, with the land smaller than the baguenal field,
mm-hmm,
with many kinds of the vegetables, you can survive with not many work.
Mm.
Yeah, I.
Yeah, as long as you are okay with that kind of food, yeah.
Mm.
A lot of people are right now asking for other food. that
oh,
you
yeah,
cannot
sure,
really
yeah, sure,
plan.
Sure, 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 sure.
So it is
of course,
always...
Of course, I don't know what you mean. Of course, yeah.
The development. So it takes a willing... I think even for people in the kampung, the issue is that when your kids start to ask for fried chicken instead of, you know, any kind of...
Mm-hmm.
Even tempeh comes from imported soya bean and stuff like
that.
Really? Sorry. But yeah, that's the difficult part is you know that it has this chain of production.
Seriously, the tempeh in here is coming from the imported...
It's slowly becoming more common because it's cheaper.
Cheaper.
Even from the seed. Because then they...
The rice too.
The rice, about the rice I hear, but about tempeh I was sure then...
soya bean.
Soybean, sugar.
So from where?
The import. From Thailand.
About rice, I know about it. Yeah.
Mm-mm.
It's cheaper.
It's cheaper.
That's so funny.
It's cheaper.
So why is expensive here?
The soybean.
Yeah.
Because they. So this is a long story,
mm-hmm.
but basically the seed. If soya bean coming from the seed that
mm-hmm.
they already imported, it creates a more susceptible, so you don't have hama, you don't have pests annoying, insects or pests, and you reduce your expenses. The farmers reduce their expenses in those chemicals.
Of course, so it's all Monsanto included thing.
But also. Some people in, say, if Niti Prayan is
mm-hmm.
closer to the city, there's a strong possibility that they have vendors coming to the Kelompok Usaha Tani promoting for...
To offer the new product,
which
is...
You can use ready-made soya beans. So it's different in parts in Jogja.
The furthest,
probably in Gunung Kidul, Monsanto is a buyer,
mm-hmm.
is opening a huge land, hectares of land, to... Sorry.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, but that's the bad news about all the village in Jogja.
You think Nepal is different? No, it's the same.
Oh, it's the same.
Yeah, of course it's the same.
Mm.
For example, Nepal is not really maybe visible when you're traveling around the country.
Because
but
you see,
you go
fields.
Bulgaria and you see that they are already in European Union, which means for Bulgaria they're still looking like the communist country.
Mm.
But everywhere they have Kaufland, Lidl, which is supermarkets, and when you're going through the country, there's a genetic modification corn, genetic modification this, experimental fields here, and every experimental fields everywhere. So they buy Bulgaria for because there's the good. They have good land and good, actually, weather for growing quick and fast and proper. And soil is full. So in Poland, if the farmers even don't know, they use it good one seeds or not. They don't. They already don't know.
Yeah, the farmers they don't know. So it takes a few generations to. Clean to clean the idea.
Yeah, that's your duty as an artist.